Okay, in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to do snaps. It's kind of like the buttons, but there aren't buttonholes for snaps. So the way you attach them, it's kind of a trick. It's not like a special snap attacher. It's using the tack feature. So, and the tack feature is over here. It's these little guys. This is edit tack, and this is tack. So I'm just gonna lay out my snaps just like I would my buttons. I'm gonna copy and paste them to the other side. And I'm just gonna tack it shut. So you're welcome to watch along. So here we go. Okay, let's find our button tool. Okay, I'm just gonna click my first, I'm gonna open up the 2D as well so I can look at both. Okay, let's zoom in. Okay. I don't think I need this library open right now. Okay. So, let's see here. I guess I will just put my first one right here. Okay. Okay, so use the default button. I'm going to click that guy. And I'm actually going to change its name to Snap at Top because this layer of fabric is on top. So Snap Top. Okay. Then let's see here. Dun, 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 dun. Category, if it's going to be in our tech pack, I think I'd rather the category be under trim, so I'll change that. And then, of course, the shape. I don't want it to be a button. I want it to be a snap. So I kind of like these ring snaps. I'm going to do that. Looks like I'm going to change it to 0.5 to fit a little bit better. You can change the thickness. You can change the weight. The material defaults to fabric matte, so I'm actually going to switch that over to metal just because I think it'd be kind of cool. The color I'm going to change maybe to like kind of like a brownish color, so maybe it'll look a little copper when I'm done. And I think that's all I really need to do for that. Okay, so I have my one button. So I'm going to use, you know, and this is bothering you. I don't know how my screen's flipped, but I'm going to click this little button right here and I'm going to click and drag my 2D pattern window. I'm going to put it back over here. I like it on that side for some reason. Okay. So to select the button, you don't use your regular selection tools. Be sure to switch to the button selection tool. Okay. Now I can click it. We can right click, we can say copy, we can right click, we can say paste. And instead of left clicking, I'm gonna go ahead and right click. And this way you can do however many you want. We can space it out. Ooh. Okay, that seems okay. And then I'll say okay. Oh, one was pasted outside the pattern piece. Oops, well, okay, it seems to work itself out. Okay, so now what I want to do is I actually want to sew this guy shut just so that it's perfectly aligned on top of itself, so it'll make it a lot easier to tack. I don't know, maybe I don't even have to do that, to be honest with you. Don't really know. Yeah, maybe I don't. Okay, I'm not gonna do it. I'll see what happens. Okay, so let's see here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and tack it shut. And I kind of want to leave the top one open. So I'm not going to tack the top one. I'm going to leave that one open. So let's get our tack tool. And I'm going to just tack. We're not going to tack it on the avatar. We're going to tack it to the actual garment. So I'll just click in the middle of this button. And I'm going to come straight across. And then just click it in the middle. That's it. One time. I'll do the same. Maybe I could copy and paste. I don't know. I've never tried that before. Let's try it. If I select you, can I copy you? Oh yeah, okay. And then what happens if I right click and do paste? Well, can I right click? Oh yeah, look at that. You can do that again. Okay. I guess so. Cool. I don't think that actually, I think I messed that one up. That's okay. Try again, paste. Okay, right click, and okay. The only thing that's kind of weird is like, I feel like it's, yeah, the lines, they just kind of got scooched over a little bit, which is kind of weird, but that's okay. I'm on the edit tack tool. Again, it's tack with a little white arrow next to it. So I can select the whole thing and just kind of scoot it where I think it needs to be. Oh, I think all of them got moved because they were all selected. Okay, I'm gonna scoot this guy a little bit over here. Okay, I think that should be good. Okay, what happens if I try sewing it or simulating? Okay. It's a little funky. So I'm going to say Command-Z. Okay. And then let's see. I'm like, what would the easiest way be to deal with this? I almost want to take all these little buttons. So let me get my edit button tool. I'm going to select all of them. Okay. I'm going to say Command X. Is that option? No. I will right click and I kind of want to say copy and then I'm going to delete. Okay. Now I want to simulate. Okay. So I'm thinking I did skip that step of sewing it. So I'm going to go back. Command Z. And I guess I'm going to remove the tacks. I like to just explore sometimes. Like, can we skip steps? Should we skip steps? In this case, the answer is no. Don't skip steps. So I guess I'll just delete these guys. Okay, so I'm going to temporarily sew this guy closed. So I'm going to pick you. Oh, is there already a stitch line there? Let me check. I'm going to delete that. There should not be a stitch line there. So I'm going to delete it for right now and just start over. Okay, so I'm going to sew this guy to this one. Okay, and then this one over here. Okay, and then now I can simulate. Great. This is what I want it to look like when my snaps are closed. So that's good. So I'm going to unsimulate. And what happens if I say edit paste, Command V? Are my buttons still there or are they gone? Paste. Oh, yay, they're still there. I did have to be in the button tool to paste. When I hit Command V, that didn't quite seem to work. Cool. So there we are. And then now I will do that tack trick again. Oops. Okay, so I'm just going to go click. Click. I don't know what's faster, copying and pasting or just doing it manually. Not sure. Okay. There we go. So it's tacked together. I'm just going to simulate. We're not going to see a huge difference because it's still sewn together. So now what I want to do is I'm going to go ahead and take out the stitching. So I'm in my edit sew tool and I'm going to hit delete on both of those stitches. Okay, now I'm going to simulate. I just hit spacebar to simulate real quickly. There we go. So now it's kind of more realistically like snapped together, you know, because like there could be like a little, your fabric could come up if it needed to. You could see like where it pulls and whatnot. But we need a snap on the bottom part here, right? Like if it's unsnapped, you should see a snap. So I'm going to put a snap here only because this part I'm leaving unbuttoned. I did try putting bottom snaps on all of it, but it really fought. Like the bottom snap was trying to come up through the fabric and I was having an issue with layers. And I eventually just decided I don't need it. So I just didn't put them there. So, okay. So anyways, I'm going to get my, you know what I might do? Yeah, I'll get my button tool and I'll just go ahead and put the button right here and I'm going to hit add and we're going to call this guy snap bottom. Okay. Okay. I'm going to go up to the top. We have snap bottom. Let's change our shape to like maybe that guy. My width, I've been working with 0.5, so I'll stick with that. My material, okay, I'm gonna change it to metal. I'll change the color to the same color as that I was using. Okay, and then let's see here. Okay, cool. Sounds good. Okay. Oh, and then what I need to do is click, drag, and drop it on this guy. There we go. Okay, cool. So then now I can simulate one last time if I want. And there you go. That's it. So now I can add, you know, fabric to my dress, and then it will look realistic if I go up and render it as well. So that's really the end of this tutorial. If you want to stick around and watch how I render, I know we're kind of new with that. I'm happy to show you how I render as well. So I'm going to first just give it some fabric real quick. So let me zoom out. Select all those pieces. I'm going to go to the library. I will choose fabric. And let's see. I think I am kind of feeling chambray today. So I'm going to click, drag, and drop. Cool. And then because I'm going to render, I can close this library. And I'm going to hit the high resolution button right here. So high res garment button. Okay, so then you simulate to see the high res take effect. And I'm trying to rotate right now. There it goes. It's a little slow, so I don't think it was really ready. I think my computer was still trying to take in the effects, so I just need to be calmer and more patient and let it do its thing. Okay. Okay, so now I'm ready to go to render. So I'm going to go up to the menu and I will choose render. And again, all of our settings, these down here are our lighting settings. If you click any of them, you can alter them under property editor. But what you're going to want to do is probably start with your image properties. Just kind of double check that this is what you want. Let's see here. For me, I like transparency, so I'm going to turn it to be transparent. You know, decide on your name. It's just going to default to whatever the last file was named, so you might want to change that. Your file path, where it's going to be saved. So I'm going to give it a new name. That's really important. So I kind of set up that. There's other properties too, but I think they're a little bit intermediate for what we need today. So now all you have to do is click here, just click one time, and it's going to start the interactive render. So it's going to render it, and it takes it a while. You can see it's like super pixelated. It's kind of filling in as we wait more and more. Okay. And then mine, I don't know, maybe I'm just not patient, but I feel like it just stays highlighted blue here. Maybe it's done, maybe it's not, I don't know. I'm just gonna wait it out. It's still kind of like staticky. So you have the option at this point to go over here to save current image. It will save it really quick and fast. It's just that it won't be as high quality as if you hit, so now I'm gonna hit stop render. It's just gonna save the current image, and I guess it's not all the way rendered. So I'm gonna hit stop, and then if I hit play, this is my final render. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. So I've had some garments that take 3.5 minutes to save. I've had some that take 30 seconds to save. So it's just rendering this image in very high quality according to your settings. And and it's just gonna save it to wherever you told it to over here in your property editor. and you just gotta wait. That's all. Another thing I could have done was I kind of wish I zoomed in since we were working with snaps and you just zoom in over here with your mouse and it'll automatically zoom in the image that would be rendered as well, which is nice. Okay, so I can just do that again. Looks like it's almost done. Okay, good. It's been saved. So I'm just going to say close. I'll go look for it later. I'm going to go ahead and do what I was mentioning that I wanted to gonna bring this guy in. So I'm going to say stop and I'm going to stop there. I'm going to click in here. Okay, maybe not. Okay, I'm going to click the interactive render so it can go back to being interactive again. There we go. Okay. So if you wanted to like rotate or anything, you can still do that. And here you go. Here you go. It's just very high quality, very detailed, taking its time. Okay. I'm just going to say stop because I know this is, it has all the settings that I want. And I'm just going to go ahead and hit the play so that, oh, it's probably going to save on top of my old picture because I didn't change the name. That's good to note. Okay, so now we're gonna get a more detailed shot. The last one took about 40 seconds. So hopefully this one will be somewhat similar. Probably bored. You don't have to keep watching this video at this point if you don't want to. Maybe you're like holding out to see like, what do they look like? Ooh, this one's taking longer. That's interesting. My snaps are pretty wide and thick. I wonder if I should next time maybe make them a little more flat. I could change that in the property editor when I was working on the 3D, 2D window, like before the render window. Okay, let's see. 44%. Oh gosh, so this one might be another 3.5 minute one. Could be my computer too. I don't know. Have a sip of water while I wait. Okay, cool. I'm gonna say open folder. Let's check these out. Let's look at them. Oh, nice. You know what's so great? It didn't save on top of my old one. It automatically added _1. So that's cool. Okay, so I'm gonna pick that guy and I'm gonna grab both of them and let's look at them. Cool. There's my render. Pretty realistic. Yeah, I like the zoomed up one. It's kind of neat. Let's see. This is one I did earlier. There you go. Okay, guys, if you guys have questions about snaps or if you have any better ideas on how to do snaps, please share. You know, I always like to learn new things. And in Clo, it's one of those programs where you can do the same thing more than one way. So love to hear from you.